Said, let me actually play more of what Lindsey Graham said this morning. Listen to this.
Just, Mr. President, you're going to win. Just knock it down a notch.
In what way?
Well, we all know that AOC and this crowd are a bunch of communists. They hate Israel. They hate our own country. They're calling the guards along our border, the Border Patrol agents, concentration camp guards. They accuse people who support Israel of doing it for the Benjamins. They're anti-Semitic. They're anti-America. Don't get down. Aim higher. We don't need to know anything about them personally. Talk about their policies.
Senator.
You see, as Sabrina's pointing out, I mean, communist, anti-Semitic, anti-American is what Lindsey Graham says. But then you also see here, the president just tweeted out most of what Lindsey Graham said in that interview. Notably, though, leaving out the part where Lindsey Graham said, just knock it down a notch and aim higher. He's calling on the president to stop. In 2019, that is what it sounds like coming from a Republican. The president clearly isn't listening, though, Estead. Do Republicans know that? And so they've just given up?
Well, I think there's a couple things happening here. One, Republicans are trying to act like this is an aberrant statement from the president, as if they could, as if the tweets that we saw are somehow out of his character. When I think to any observer who's been following along with this president, this is in line with what he has been and who he has been for the entirety of certainly his political career and largely his adult life. I mean, let's remember, this is a president that called into question the fairness of a Mexican judge. This is a president that seemed to defend some white nationalists in Charlottesville. This is a president who made his political kind of first foray into American politics by the kind of racist conspiracy theory of birtherism. And this is a person who has never apologized for calling for the Central Park Five to calling them convicted when they were exonerated. So this is more in line with this president's history. And we're seeing Republicans try to paint it as an aberration because that's in their political interest.
Are you yourself surprised at what some people might say is a bit of a moral failure or a little craven of so many Republicans who simply have not stood up and said anything about President Trump's, what you've just called, racist tweets?
Well, it's concerning to me that there are people that think that's okay, that kind of behavior is okay. One of the things I've learned going to church on Sundays, and you know, I don't care which faith you believe in, there is some story to this point. And when Jesus was asked what is the most important commandment, he said to love thy Lord God with all your heart, mind, and soul. But he said equally as important is to love your neighbor like yourself. And I think we need to remember more of that, and I think we'd be better off.